after, in the year 2005, Evo Morales won the elections. We had a new constitution. We changed the name of our state. It's now plurinational state of Bolivia, recognizing that we have more than 30 nations inside Bolivia of indigenous people. That was a great, great moment, and it lasted for 4 years.
I used to be at the leadership of Syriza for 11 years. Syriza had a program which it was responsive to people's needs. The problem was that we didn't have concrete action plans. How are we going to implement these policies? I realized at some point that there are several certain limits in what we can achieve if we do politics in a traditional way. We have to take into consideration the complexity of the society, the complexity of being in the government and having to do with state institutions which are bureaucratic in nature, aligned with the interests of the elites for so many years. So you need to have a transformation strategy. One major thing is the decentralization of decisions. We are talking about a different model of leadership, which is a necessary thing for our societies in general. Complex societies cannot be governed anymore by authoritarian, in an authoritarian or hierarchical way. We have to distribute the decision-making processes, and the government could have, and the leadership could be a facilitator of this democratic process, because if we do not take into consideration and we do not bring in different perspectives, our decisions will be wrong.
In the Bolivian case, we began to do things to stay in power. Bolivia has always lived from extractivism: silver, then rubber, then tin, then gas. What we wanted to do was to move to be an agroecological country. We could have moved to renewable energy, to ecotourism, but we didn't do that. The government continued with extractivism of gas. There were no other alternatives. They were. But the easiest one to remain in the government and to get power was to extract more gas, sell the gas, have more income, and of course you can do a lot of social programs and you can have more power.
This is a very crucial issue we have to find a way to overcome. We were going to have a conflict with our lenders. The lenders were controlling the basic functions of our society through liquidity and funding, and we should be able to take on as a society collectively to take on basic functions to create degrees of autonomy in order to be able to engage in this fight. We have to appeal to people's availability. People were willing in Greece to become active and engaged in this fight, but we didn't have the mechanism to receive this availability and transform it into social power. When the negotiation with the lenders went bad, the government, my comrades, transformed the rhetoric from delivering to the people what they need into remaining to power as the best way to serve the people, regardless of the content of the policy that we are going to implement.
I think that we made a mistake in the case of Bolivia, because when we won the elections, the most strongest social force was not the political instrument, it was the social movement. Mm-hmm. And instead of straightening that, we began to incorporate the main leaders of all the organizations into the state apparatus. I think that the strategy is more complicated than what we thought. It's not to take state power and transform the world or society, but to look for state power to build our counter power, even for the revolutionary leaders that are going to go into the government. So it is a strategy that has to combine
two key elements,
and I think that maybe this is the way to sort out this deep problem that we have seen in many places.